So yeah, from an evolving threat landscape, I probably, you know, I guess in general, when I think about threat landscapers, what do you care about? Where does it live? You know, what do you have to do to protect it, right? And if you sort of tie that to internet infrastructure, you know, the sort of things come to mind are the internet routing system, BGP, right, which is a web of trust. And, you know, I sort of refer to that as routing by rumor. So I tell you something and you choose to use it or not and choose to propagate it or not and so forth. There's no central authority today. And sort of makes that system highly resilient, but it also makes it very prone to errors. So hard to tell, was it an error, was it malicious, or was it intentional or not? And then the next one's a domain name system, the DNS, right? Nobody uses IP addresses. They're going to be types or encodes names typically for resilience and agility and other things. And it's a hierarchical structure with a transitive trust property. So basically, I rely on people I may not even be able to enumerate. And we see a lot of attacks on that. So other people say, if I want to attack example.com, I can attack root servers or .com or example.com directly, or I can attack this third party over here that enables that. And so, those sort of systemic dependencies, in particular the DNS, are really problematic. We've seen irrational attacks. We're going to talk about that a bit more later. But targeting those, people say, hey, I don't have to directly attack that big entity. I can attack someone in their online supply chain, and if I do that, I can accomplish the same mission. So that's problematic. Web PKI, right? The padlock you used to see in your web browser, right? I mean, iPhone's probably got 180. Certificate authorities embedded in a root trust store, and if any one of those is compromised, they're all compromised. So you're only as secure as the least secure of all those at the end of the day. So what does that mean for you from an availability perspective? So I do think that all these things are the security starting to improve, but I think that with more things, more interconnected, with more sensitive data, at the end of the day, to Chris's point, the velocity, the volume, the firepower of an attacker. And what's in store, if you lose that information, either the data itself or the availability of some piece of some service or information, could be really, really problematic. And so I think the culmination of those.